afternoon and a very warm welcome to the Cathedral Church of St. Peter and St. Paul, your Washington National Cathedral, for this service of Choral Evensong. We gather, as Christians have throughout the centuries, to offer prayer and praise to Almighty God as the day draws to a close. The choir will lead us through much of this service, but you're invited to join in the prayers and the creed as indicated, and as well to bring your own prayers. We begin with hymn 47. Peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." O Lord, open thou our lips. Speed to save us.
O Lord, grace to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and forever.
Amen.
lesson from the prophet Hosea, wherein we hear of God's judgment against Israel. Yet I have been the Lord your God ever since the land of Egypt. You know no God but me, and besides me, there is no Savior. It was I who fed you in the wilderness, in the land of drought. When I fed them, they were satisfied. They were satisfied, and their heart was proud. Therefore, they forgot me. So I will become like a lion to them. Like a leopard, I will lurk beside the way. I will fall upon them like a bear robbed of her cubs, and will tear open the covering of their heart. There, I will devour them like a lion, as a wild animal would mangle them. I will destroy you, O Israel. Who can help you? Where now is your king, that he may save you? Where in all your cities are your rulers, of whom you said, "Give me a king and rulers"? I gave you a king in my anger, and I took him away in my wrath. Ephraim's iniquity is bound up. His sin is kept in store. The fangs of childbirth come for him. But he is an unwise son, for at the proper time, he does not present himself at the mouth of the womb. Shall I ransom them from the power of Sheol? Shall I redeem them from death? O death, where are your plagues? O Sheol, where is your destruction? Compassion is hidden from my eyes. Here ends the lesson.
My soul doth magnify, doth magnify.
A lesson from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, wherein we hear of the death of John the Baptist. At that time, Herod, the ruler, heard reports about Jesus. And he said to his servants, "This is John the Baptist. He has been raised from the dead, and for this reason, these powers are at work in him. For Herod had arrested John, bound him, and put him in prison on account of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife. Because John had been telling him, 'It is not lawful for you to have her.' Though Herod wanted to put him to death, he feared the crowd because they regarded him as a prophet. But when Herod's birthday came, the daughter of Herodias danced before the company, and she pleased Herod so much that he promised on oath to grant her whatever she might ask. Prompted by her mother, she said, 'Give me the head of John the Baptist here on a platter.' The king was grieved, yet out of regard for his oath and for the guests, he commanded it to be given. He sent and had John beheaded in the prison. The head was brought on a platter and given to the girl, who brought it to her mother. His disciples came and took the body and buried it. They went and told Jesus." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
In heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the state. Ministers with a righteousness.
And make me righteous again, a joyful.
O Lord, save thy people.
And bless thy name every
time. Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is a mother that fighteth for us, but only them, O God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us. Almighty and everlasting God, who art always more ready to hear than we to pray, and art wont to give more than either we desire or deserve, pour down upon us the abundance of thy mercy, forgiving us those things whereof our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things which we are not worthy to ask, but through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Lord God, whose Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, triumphed over the powers of death and prepared for us our place in the New Jerusalem, grant that we, who have this day given thanks for his resurrection, may praise thee in that city of which he is the light, and where he liveth and reigneth forever and ever. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On this day which the Lord has made, let us join together and offer our petitions to Almighty God. We pray for the church spread across the world and for all the holy people of God. We pray especially for Michael, our presiding bishop, for Marianne, our bishop, for all who serve this cathedral church, for all who worship here. This day we give a special thanks for the ministry of our boy choristers. We pray for the good earth that is our home and ask that God will inspire us and ever strengthen us with the will and courage to preserve it. We remember and pray for all those in any need this day, for the sick and suffering, for the poor and those who have no place to call home, for all those who live in places where there is war or violence. We pray, too, for all the departed, that they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or suffering. And we pray for all those who mourn. And now, in the silence of our own hearts, we offer our own prayers. Accept these our prayers, O Father, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now I invite you to join in praying the general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Our closing hymn is hymn 37.